85 years ago, Chevrolet brought us the Suburban, and it's been really popular. But it was ready for a refresh, and now we have a refresh with a lot of major changes that will impress you. We'll take a look at the 2021 Chevrolet Suburban. Welcome back to the channel. I'm Lauren Fix, and today we're going to test drive the 2021 Chevrolet Suburban. This is a very important vehicle to them because it is the largest vehicle in the segment. It is a full-size SUV that has three rows that adults can sit in the third row, which you don't see in a lot of three-row SUVs. In addition, this has ability on-road and off-road, and if you're going to tow something, this is a great solution for towing people and campers or trailers. We'll show you that as well. If this is your first time to the channel, we do more than car reviews. We give you great information so you can have money and have car smarts. Make sure to hit that subscribe and that little bell so you don't miss anything. There are three major changes in the 2021 Suburban. And one of those is it's about 1% longer. It gives you more room for the third row. It also gives you more cargo capacity. In addition, they've lowered the floor about 5.3 inches. Why is that important? Well, that means the second and the third row are flat, easier to get in and out, also good for storing things because this is about having multiple abilities of hauling people and towing. The third major change for the Suburban is the fact that they've added more technology and a lot of really great features. We're going to show that to you in our Car Coach Reports ratings. We have different categories from performance, handling, quality, build, seating, all these factors. In the end, we'll give you a Car Coach Reports rating so you know what you're going to get before you get in the car to take it for a test drive. Remember, it's always important to test drive one of these vehicles before you own it and make sure it fits in your garage or wherever you park it, because it is pretty large and it is in charge. Let's go for a ride. There are three engines available for the Suburban. The 5.3 liter V8 with 355 horsepower is standard on most trim levels. The 6.2 liter V8 with 420 horsepower is standard on the high country trim level. And my favorite is the Duramax 3 liter six-cylinder turbo diesel with 277 horsepower and a strong 460 pound-feet of torque. All three engines are matched with the new 10-speed automatic transmission with the electronic shifter control. I'm still not a fan of this electronic shifter because it's a pull, not a push. I don't know, it does the job. It's just weird. It's not intuitive to me. This is a local drag track and they let me play around on their back road. Here's our 0 to 60 launch. There's a lot of motor pulling here. Wow, that's pretty. This is a big vehicle and a lot of energy to move it. For the 5.3 liter, which is pretty good considering this is the entry-level engine, you have the optional 6.2 liter and the optional diesel, which is my ultimate favorite because you buy horsepower and you drive torque, and I love a torquey truck. This earned a 9, which is pretty darn good. When you're handling a big vehicle like this, there's a lot of factors to consider. One of them being brakes, one of them being steering input, one of them being ride. Those are all factors when it comes to handling. Now, on this particular vehicle, this is the Z71, and it has the air ride suspension, the magnetic air ride suspension. So it's got different modes depending upon what you're doing with it. And I think that's really smart. Part of all of the handling is the ability to be an automatic four-wheel drive. It also has a button on the left that you can do four-wheel high, four-wheel low, or two-wheel drive. Again, what are you doing with it? If the conditions are in question, you can put it in all-wheel drive automatic. And if it feels slippage, the car is smart enough with all the computers to be able to adjust so that you can keep this big boat on the road. And that is one of the factors. You have to be comfortable with a vehicle this size. I'm used to driving trucks. I've got a lot of truck experience for on-road, not as much on off-road. But one of the factors that's important to me is to be able to park this thing. And yes, it's got a round view camera. It's got 9 cameras. You can do pretty much anything, but it is a large vehicle and you have to get comfortable with the size. It's very ominous. There are 6 different trim packages and each of them have different factors to them. But this particular one, I really like the look. I'm just really impressed with the overall look and a lot of things about this vehicle, making it not so old school, but making it look more modern. Although this vehicle still has that huge factor, when it came to handling, it earned an 8. Obviously, when you have a people hauler like this, plus you're towing something, safety is top priority. There's a lot of features on this that are standard and that I appreciate, including the fact that there is trailer brakes already built in to this for the electrical component, so it's one less thing that you have to do if you are hauling. One of the standard features on the Suburban is a forward collision warning, cross traffic alert. I know that they offer a lot of other features in different trim levels. If you are loading this thing up, there are still a few safety features missing. You need that when you have a vehicle this size. Pedestrian cross traffic alert is all that is just so important. But because there's a few things that are missing, and it's true on the Silverado as well. So if you look at our Silverado review, which is a his turn, her turn review with Paul Bryan, you'll see that we found these same features to be missing. Just a few safety features. Are they available on other competitors? Well, there really isn't a competitor, but the Cadillac has everything. So it's hard to compare an apple to maybe an orange. But in reality, for safety, it's missing a few items that I'd love to see on this vehicle. That would be nice. Night vision would be great with a vehicle of this size because you're probably towing at night. You got family with you. Has a lot of features. Really impressive. On a scale of 1 to 10, though, it earned an 8. When you have a vehicle of this size, especially when I kind of call it a boat because it's so huge, you need to have cameras, and they've done that. It's got a round view cameras. There is an optional backup camera that turns the backup regular mirror into a camera. That's a Cadillac item that is now passing its way down. We saw it even in the Buick Encore GX, which we were really impressed. The lower sills are important, the big windshield, but when you have the headrests up all the way in the second and third row, it kind of limits the visibility, which is why you need that camera in the rear view mirror. Unless you're not going to be leaving the headrests up all the time, when it came to visibility, it earned a 9, and that's pretty good for a vehicle of this size. Everyone knows seating is important to me, and it is. And in this vehicle, there is two-way lumbar. That's it, both driver and passenger side. There is some other adjustability. This is a comfortable seat for multiple size people. There's adjustable steering wheel, which is also important. But there are times when this vehicle is just not comfortable, and that's when you're going around corners like this. I feel like I'm going to slide to the side. And that's because the bolsters are not big. Again, this is a personal thing. I just want you to know all the factors. Let's take a look at the second and the third row, and we'll give it a rating. One of the really nice things they did with Suburban is they lowered the floor about 5.3 inches. What that did is it created a flat floor, which is great for kids to get in the back seat or adults, but it also allows you to put items on the floor, which is also helpful depending upon what your situation is and what you're doing. Here in the second row, there is a lot of adjustments and a lot of niceties considering the price point of this vehicle. There are manual adjustments on the seat that can go forward and back 5 inches, which allows easy access to the third row. But in addition to that, these seats fold down, and you've got the third row, which folds down, which gives it the most cargo capacity. We'll show you that in a second. But looking at the seating comfort here, it's pretty good design for multiple different bodies. There's armrests here as well, and they're real nicely built. The second row also features optional screens. These are huge. They're almost 13 inch. They look like an iPad. They're individual, and they can be adjusted from the front. In addition, if I decide that I want to go to a pizza place or I want to share my content with the other two screens, I can do that. Remember, the driver cannot see the screen while it's functioning. That is a safety feature. It's not available in the front row. There is also included part of that very expensive entertainment package, these really nice wireless Chevrolet headsets, very nicely done. They store here in these pockets that are directly in front of the people in the back seat. There's two cup holders, and this center console slides back an additional 4 inches, which allows you to have easier reach to the cup holders, especially if you've got kids and they can't reach that far. Further down, you've got climate control. You have two USB-C connections and two HDMI connections. So this is the ability to charge everything. If you're still using USB, you'll have to drag a cord to the front. But they've really thought about all that. In addition, further down, there is a regular wall outlet. So if you've got to charge something that has an HDMI connection, especially if you're bringing some sort of player or game station that allow each of the two screens to function. In the door, you have these amazing Bose audio system, as well as really nicely detailed and soft panels with a window lift and a door lock, which is really nice. In the third row, there's plenty of room. Surprisingly, I'm 5'8", and I've got headroom here with the headrests up that gives you the ability to still be comfortable. And my knees aren't past my throat, and I'm all legs. So this is actually truly comfortable. You could get three back here, two in the midsection, and then two in front. That would seat up to 9 people if you go with the bench seat. So that means the Suburban can fit up to 7 in this configuration, and this is the Z71 package. In the doors, you've got a button right here, just right in front of the cup holders, that allows you to put this seat forward. Isn't that nice? Really nice, simple, process simple button. You got a cup holder, a spot for snacks or whatever you want. And then you've got a USB-C connection here. Same thing on the other side and an individual vent. And there's lighting. They really thought about all the details. I am really impressed with the accessibility to get in and out of the back of the Suburban, both the second row and the third row, the way the seats fold down. The only disappointment is the fact that it's two-way lumbar. I mean, this car really has everything of a premium vehicle like a Cadillac, which would be the upscale version if you're looking at an Escalade, and that's a lot more expensive. Overall, looking at seating comfort for all three rows, and I really love the third row because there's nothing bigger on the marketplace, I had to give it a 7. One of the three largest improvements for the Suburban is not just the longer length, the lower floor, but the upgrade in technology. I do like the fact that there are regular gauges in front, and then you can adjust the center screen between the two gauges. It's about 8 inches in size, allows you to make the changes for what you want. There's the transmission, which are buttons. They're calling them push buttons, but in reality, they're pull buttons. You may push the park, but to go into reverse neutral driving, you have to pull up on the lever. So make sure you're aware that it's not a push button there. It's kind of a pull button. It's just called like a button transmission. There's the ability to go lower, up and down for low gear, and that's good if you're towing something or going up a hill or you're off-roading. Again, it depends on what you're doing. Moving to the center screen, you've got a good size 10-inch screen. It has all the things that you want. This maps are kind of outdated, so use your Apple CarPlay, your Android Auto. I think that's going to be better. Remember, there is also Wi-Fi in this vehicle, so you can connect to Google if you want, whatever you want to use. As far as the music, audio system is great. You've got your satellite radio, you've got HD, it's Bose, so you can't go wrong. You've got the ability to connect your phone very simply. There's wireless capability as well down on the center console. You can access your climate control in the center screen, also on the buttons down below. It just depends what you want to do, so you have lots of options when it comes to technology. You've got your vents going further down, you've got your home button, and a lot of information that might be helpful to you. One of the technologies that General Motors has put a lot of effort into in their truck line and now in the Suburban, as well as some of the other larger vehicles, is their trailer towing package. So if you have a vehicle behind you, in this case I do, you get the ability to see what's going on behind you. So first thing is your status. What's going on? You've got your connections, your maintenance, and your vehicle. You got your, that'll tell you what's going on under checklist. You'll have your conventional checklist of what you're looking for. You can put your trailer in and it'll actually tell you based on your trailer, see the guest trailer, what's the information, the accessories and so forth. And you can create a profile if you've got more than one trailer, and I happen to own more than one. So you can go into your settings and set what you're looking for. Now, when you go into reverse, in this case, you pull the switch, you can see there's a trailer and I need to line up my hitch with this. So if you see, I can turn this and I can say, well, wait a minute, I need a different shot. I can actually change the shot. And then here, that's forward, that's reverse. I want to see what's going on the right. I got this hedgerow here. I don't want to hit that. So I want to see where my wheel is. And let's see, and there's the trailer hitch. I can see where that is, and as I go further in, it's going to tell me you're lining up. And over here, this will give you your trailer information and based on what you have. And then, of course, you've got your around view camera. So there's a lot of different things that are really important when you're trying to connect a truck to a trailer rather than having someone back there. And having 9 different cameras is truly a great technology. As far as technology, up to date, to the max when it comes to USB-C connections. That is the way everyone's moving. I know Apple's moving that way. Androids have moved that way. iPads are charging that way. So they're on top of it because people are going to own these vehicles for a long time and they're going to be sold used down the road. So you want to be prepared for that. So that was really smart because a lot of manufacturers have not gotten to USB-C. One of the technology features that they always talk about is the start-stop technology, the auto-stop. There's a million different titles for it. I'm not a fan of it. It's not bad on this car. Usually I shut it off like immediately. Hate that stuff. Hate lane change departure. But their setup is not invasive. It does the job without being in your face and being a distraction for that matter. So they've done an excellent job on that technology. The ability to move things around and thinking about how consumers use this car, they did a great job. Overall, for technology, it earned a 7. There are a ton of features on this car. One of the ones that's missing, in my opinion, is air-cooled seats. Yeah, they have heated seats for the back or the bottom, really well designed, but you need air-cooled seats. I think that's critical and important in a vehicle of this size. This is a black interior. We're in the middle of summer. It's like 90 degrees outside. You can crank the AC, but you need some air-cooled seats. Now, as far as features, we went through some of that in technology. When you look all the way to the left, you've got your controls for whether you want the vehicle up or down, depending upon your situation. You've got automatic, four high, four low. You've got your adjustable headlights, your trailer brakes, your ability to shut off some of these safety features, the park assist, the on off. There's really a lot here. On top of that, going over to the center area, just to the right of the center screen, which is a great feature, there's this really cool little access door for putting, I don't know, whatever you want. Going further down, you've got all your controls, easy to use, pretty basic. If you've owned a GM car in the past, you'll have no problems operating this, and it's a pretty intuitive system. There are two cup holders in the center, plus two on the back side of the console. If you press the button, it's slides back and forth. Huge glove box, great storage in the doors, multiple levels both in the second row and the first row. That's great. There are grab handles on the passenger side. You kind of need that if you're going off-road. From the upper console, you can put down the third row, which is great. If your kids come and they've got gear, someone's putting something in the back, you're waiting for them, you press the button up top, the third row folds down. You can tilt the sunroof, but you can also move the cover back, and I think that's really important as well. I'm a huge fan of OnStar. There's a button here. When you hit OnStar, you'll have a concierge who can guide you, help you if you're in need. That's been around for a long time and is one of the positive, big positives when it comes to General Motors vehicles. There are a lot of features on this vehicle. I mean, I could go on, and there's a list that's so long, I'd give you an article that's thousands of words. I suggest before you go and buy a Suburban that you look on their website for General Motors and see what fits your needs so you kind of know what you want and what you need. But when it came to features overall, it deserved an 8. The design on the front of the new Suburban is a bit different. One of the things I like is this new grille. Now, this is the Z71 package. There are 6 different trim levels, so each design for each trim level is going to be completely different. All Suburbans come with the LED headlights and taillights. That's great because visibility is so important. It's 80% of your driving decision. And you look along the grille itself. One of the things I like down below is the Z71 has the red hooks and the red skid plate, which makes it really stand out. This vehicle is all blacked out. It looks like it's a government vehicle pulling up in your driveway. Pretty cool, actually. I like it. Then you've got this nice flat brushed metal piece here. All of this is to give it great looks and great style. And then if you look underneath, you can see that this has got plenty of ground clearance for on and off-road capability. One of the things it also has the ability to shutter some of the grille when you're at high speeds for aerodynamics. Again, that has to do with fuel economy. Our Z71 package that we're test driving today comes with 20-inch wheels. Some of the packages come with off-road, but they come with all-season tires. But this vehicle can pretty much go through anything. The running boards are fixed on the Suburban. There is the ability to lower the vehicle, and there's a button for that inside. Again, that's one of the features, but this is great for helping people get in the vehicle. I kind of wish it would fold up just to make it nice and smooth and cleaner and even more like government official looking. Across the back is a huge tailgate. It is Amazon. This might be one of the times where a split tailgate makes sense, but instead it is a gigantic tailgate. For design, we gave it an 8. When it comes to quality, it's not just exterior and interior components. It's the build quality of the vehicle, and this is on a truck chassis, so it is built rugged. On the inside, there's real stitching on the interior, which I really appreciate. Soft touch everything, which makes a big difference, especially when you're living inside this vehicle. But just the way they thought about a lot of the components when it came to quality, I think they had to step up their game, but you couldn't go as far as a Cadillac, otherwise you might as well buy a Cadillac. So for quality, I gave it a 9. Behind the third row, there's a lot of storage, about 10% more. This is about 41 cubic feet. Fold down the third row and you have about 92.9 cubic feet. That's a lot. I mean, there's not a lot of vehicles in the marketplace that could hold that much junk in the trunk. Fold down the second row and you have 144 cubic feet. That's one heck of a lot of storage. When you're looking at value, the Suburban comes in at $51,700 to start. Now you want the goodies, but when you're looking at its only real competitor, which is the Cadillac, this is actually a deal. When I looked at this vehicle and I drove it before we started reviewing it, I have to say I thought it was going to be over $100,000, but it wasn't. So for value, we gave it an 8. Overall, the 2021 Chevrolet Suburban is impressive over its previous generation. You can't really compare it to the Cadillac. You can look at the Ford Expedition. It does have an XL version. they're trying to make some big moves, but this is not an excursion. They haven't made excursions in many years. So really, you don't have a competitor in the Suburban market segment. Price point, enter at about $51,700, is pretty darn good. And what you're getting for your money is really good value. When you total up all the categories, forget the competition because there really isn't any. You need three adult full row seats that can seat a minimum of seven people. This is going to be your solution unless you're going to like a Sprinter van or something at that size. When you're looking at the total of 82, that's pretty impressive. If you got value from this video, make sure to give it a like and a share. We want your comments down below. Did you take one for a test drive? Did you buy one? Have you owned a Suburban over the last 85 years? They've made a lot of big improvements, and I think the keyword is big. Thank you so much for watching. We appreciate your support on our Patreon page, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time.